the kids because I'm Chivo. This is Fred.
Hey, guys.
And we're going to sing another song. So everyone stand up and let's praise the Lord.
One of our favorite songs, right, Chilo?
Yeah.
Jump.
Changed my life, you gave me a new start, gave me a new start. You changed my life, it's all because of you, all because of you. You make me smile, you gave me a new heart, gave me a new heart.
You make me smile,
you make me smile, it's all because of you, all because of you. All because of you.
Are you guys ready? Come on.
All I want to do when I think about you, when I think about you, Jesus. All I want to do when I think about you.
Are you ready to jump? Here we go.
Saved my soul, you gave me a new song, gave me a new song.
You saved my soul,
you saved my soul. It's all because of you, all because of you.
You make me strong,
you make me strong. I know you're with me, I know you're with me.
You make me strong,
you make me strong. It's all because of you, all because of you. All because of you.
Come on, sing it out loud, guys.
All I want to do when I think about you, when I think about you, Jesus. All I want to do when I think about you.
Here we go.
I want to jump.
So break it down, guys.
When I think about you.
Come on, clap it up right there.
Everyone, come along. Grab a friend. And
come on, grab
song.
Your brother, grab your sister, grab your dad, grab your mom. Here we go, let's jump together.
Everybody jump. Everybody jump. Everybody jump.
Come on, sing it out loud.
All I want to do when I think about you, when I think about you, Jesus. All I want to do when I think about you, we're gonna jump.
Hey, 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 hey.
We're gonna jump.
Hey, 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 hey.
We're gonna jump.
Good job, guys.
And now it's time for God's Amazing Animals with Clive and Ian. An extraordinary look at some of God's most extraordinary creatures.
I'm Clive.
I'm Ian. And we're both human beings.
But we get to study God's amazing animals.
Hello there, I'm Clive.
And I'm Ian.
And today we're visiting the Galapagos Islands off the coast of South America to catch sight of a truly amazing animal, the Galapagos marine iguana.
Right. Oh, look, there's a whole bunch of marine iguanas right there.
The marine iguanas of the Galapagos Islands are the only seagoing lizards in the world.
They don't look very seagoing to me. They're just lying there on the land.
Yes, well, the iguanas have to lie out in the sun to store up heat so that when they dive into the water, they don't get cold.
Do you think we'll see any of them dive in today?
Let's take a look.
Nothing yet. But what's all that white stuff on the tops of their heads?
It's salt.
They must eat a lot of pretzels to get that much salt on their heads.
No, these iguanas don't eat pretzels, they eat seaweed. But seaweed is very salty, and to make sure the iguanas don't get sick, they have salt glands in their eyes and nose that allow them to sneeze out the extra salt.
So they sneeze salt and it falls on their heads?
Yep.
That's disgusting. Let's see if one of them will sneeze.
Fellas, I don't think you're going to catch any of those iguanas sneezing salt or diving into the water.
No, I'm sure we will. Any minute now.
But we've gone over this. You're not in the Galapagos Islands. You only have that one shot of those iguanas that you keep playing over and over.
Uh-oh, it looks like two of the iguanas are fighting. Take a look. What a doozy that one was. I thought they might come after us next.
Well, I stand corrected. And there you have it, the marine iguana, just one more of God's amazing animals.
I'm Clive.
I'm Ian, and we're both human beings.
But we get to study God's amazing animals.
Welcome everybody to Kids Club. My name is Vicky, and I'm so excited that you're here today. Bienvenidos todos al Club de Niños. Mi nombre es Vicky. Estoy muy contenta que están acá con nosotros hoy. So today we're going to be talking about courage. What is courage? Courage is standing up for what you think is right, what the Bible says is right. So if a group of your friends are going to make you do something, but you know it's wrong, don't do it. But it's easier said than done. You have to have the courage to say no, to say I'm not going to take part of whatever you're doing because I know it's wrong. ¿Qué es tener coraje? Vamos a estar hoy hablando de coraje. ¿Qué es tener coraje? Es levantando por lo que nosotros pensamos que está bien, lo que la Biblia dice está bien, y defender esos principios. Un amiguito de ustedes puede decir, vamos a hacer tal cosa, y ustedes saben que está mal. Saben acá en tu corazón que está muy, muy, muy mal. Entonces, no lo van a hacer. Pero algunas veces, por la vida, para no perder un amigo o algo, para decir, bueno, qué sé yo, no es algo tan malo. Pero no, necesitamos tener el coraje para decir no. No podemos tener miedo. Y hasta esta remera que tuvimos en el campamento de jóvenes el año pasado, dice fearless, no tener miedo. Y eso es, los explico que no podemos ser esclavos del miedo. Que algunas veces sí lo necesitamos levantar para lo que nosotros creemos. Y hay gente que se puede poner mal con nosotros, pero nosotros no podemos tener miedo a lo que ellos piensan. Last year in youth, we had a camp called Fearless. And it really said that not to be slaves of fear. And that is something super important, to have courage. We can't, it shouldn't matter what other people are gonna say. We should stand firm in what the Bible says and defend those principles, because that is super important. So right now I'm gonna be explaining to you guys a story from the Bible in which these characters from the Bible had to use courage to stand up for what they knew was right and the principles of not having to worship other gods. They had to stand up against the king in order to defend God and to defend what is said in the Bible. Ahora vamos a estar leyendo un pasaje de la Biblia. Te voy a estar diciendo una historia de unos personajes de la Biblia que necesitaban defenderse del rey. Defenderse del rey, y eso requiere un montón de coraje. Entonces ahora vamos a leer esto. Alright guys, story time. So today we're going to be talking about King Nebuchadnezzar. King Nebuchadnezzar made a large statue of himself. It was made of gold, and when they would play the specific music, everybody would have to stop what they're doing. So if you're walking your dog or getting milk from the grocery store, you would have to stop what you're doing to bow down to this king. If you wouldn't, you would be thrown into the furnace. That's the law. There's no in-betweens. If you wouldn't do that, you would be thrown into the furnace. So, three people that were all followers of Christ, Sedrak, Mesach, and Abednego, something like that, they did not bow down when that music came because they believed in the Bible, and the Bible said do not worship any other gods. What do you think happened? Were they thrown? Were they not? They were thrown. They were thrown in that furnace, all three of them. What's going to happen next is very, very interesting. When the king Nebuchadnezzar went to see the furnace, he thought that they all died. That they all died they wouldn't be like walking around. What did King Nebuchadnezzar see? They were all walking around. But there weren't three. There were four. But wait, Vicky, I thought you said there were only three. Yeah, three went in. But there were four right there. And that was an angel that God sent to be with them and to protect them. So then King Nebuchadnezzar said, come out, all three of you. And said, God is with you and he's going to protect you. But imagine how much courage that took just to stand up against the king of that place, to stand up, get up against him and say, no, I'm not going to do that because my God said that's wrong. And I'm going to listen to my God. And that's how we should be. We shouldn't have fear about what's going to happen, but we should let God take control, because just like the angel was there with all three of them, that angel is going to be with you and God is always going to be with you. So do not have fear. Ahora es tiempo de historia. Entonces, el rey Nebuchadnezzar hizo una estatua muy grande de oro. Y en esa estatua, cuando ponían una música especial, específica, necesitaban todos parar lo que estaban haciendo para adorar a esa estatua. Loco, ¿no? Entonces, no importaba lo que estabas haciendo. Si estabas agarrando leche del supermercado o estabas caminando tu perrito, necesitabas parar lo que estabas haciendo para adorar a esta estatua. Bueno, pero había tres personas, Sadrach, Mesach y Abednego, algo así, ponele, que dijeron no, no vamos a hacer eso porque en la Biblia dice que no podemos hacer eso y que nada más podemos adorar al Dios. Y eso es todo. Entonces cuando la musiquita se tocó, no, ellos no adoraron. ¿Qué pensás que pasó? Bueno, citaban ir a hablar con el rey. Y el rey los mandó a este horno. Este horno muy, muy, muy como que quema. Que nadie que entra sale vivo. Todos mueren ahí adentro. Entonces los tres entraron a ese horno. Después el rey quería, se fue ahí para mirar. Y vio, porque pensó que nada, ya estaban muertos. Como que ya estaban, qué sé yo. No, ¿sabes qué pasó? Los tres estaban caminando alrededor, pero no era nada más tres, había cuatro. Pero Vicky, pensé que nada más dijiste que había tres. Sí, te dije que nada más entraron tres, pero estaban cuatro y el cuarto era un ángel. ¡Qué emocionante! Que había un ángel con ellos, que Dios los estaba protegiendo y para que estén bien. Entonces nada más le estaba para pasar porque Dios estaba con ellos. ¡Wow! ¡Qué fascinante! Entonces cuando salió el rey Nebuchadnezzar le dijo, salen a los tres, le dijo, Dios está con ustedes y lo va a proteger. Y bueno, pero imagínate cuánto coraje requiere eso para defender lo que dice la Biblia al rey de tu lugar, de tu país. ¡Qué locura! ¿No? Bueno, pero nosotros no podemos tener temor y necesitamos hacer esas cosas. No importa qué pequeño, qué grande es, necesitamos tener el coraje para hacer eso. Como cada semana tengo algo para que ustedes puedan hacer como una actividad, esta semana tenemos como este cuadro, que es cosas que podemos vencer para tener coraje. Entonces acá en el medio es el papel que dice, esta semana voy a tener coraje en... Entonces son tres cosas que necesitas poner. Entonces, acá tengo varios ejemplos por al lado. Esta es una luna. Entonces, hay gente que tiene miedo a la oscuridad. Que está bien, pero vamos a vencer ese miedo. Porque el miedo no es del Señor. Entonces, si tienes miedo a la oscuridad, lo que puedes hacer es ir a tu cuarto con tu mami y tu papi a tu mano. Paga la luz y están con tu mami y tu papi en la mano así para que sepas que estás bien. Y tengas la luz apagada por un minuto. Después cuando puedes un minuto, sabes, sí, lo puedo hacer, no importa, 5 minutos, 10 minutos. Y así hasta que te sentís confiado que puedes hacer mucho más y hasta que no puedes estar dormido solo en tu cuarto sin tu mami y tu papi. Pero paso a paso, porque se puede hacer, lo van a poder hacer. Acá tenemos un micrófono. Mucha gente tiene temor a hablar en público. Si eso sos vos, puedes hacer que tu mamá o tu papá te graben un video y después lo publican en una de las redes sociales. Porque eso requiere mucho coraje. Pero lo pueden hacer. Yo sé que sí lo pueden hacer. Y acá tenemos una montaña. Hay gente que tiene miedo a las alturas. No sé qué pueden hacer con algo de las alturas ahora que estamos en cuarentena. Pero ustedes saben muy bien. Si si le viene una idea, hacelo con sus mamis y sus papis ahí al lado tuyo siempre. Entonces podemos estar bien y podemos sacar estos miedos que tenemos y tener el coraje y pedirle a Dios que lo saque todo este temor que tenemos. So, like you guys always know, I make an activity when I'm here. And so today we're doing a courage board. So right here it says, this week I will have courage too. So you would put three things that you're gonna have to have more courage. Whatever it is, whatever you think that there's a lot of fear that doesn't let you do it, you're gonna say, God, please help me in these three things. So you're being more intentional, you're being more specific, which is always great. It's always something wonderful. Siempre siendo más intencional y más específico es algo fabuloso y siempre te va a ayudar llegar a esa meta, llegar a lo que vos querés hacer. Entonces, right here, we have a moon. So some people are scared of like the dark and when it comes, like when it's nighttime. So if that's you, you could turn off all the lights, but be with your mom and your dad on your side and have the lights off for like a minute. Complete darkness for a minute. You think you could do it? I think you could do it. I'm pretty sure you could do it. And then but your parents are there with you. So you know everything's gonna be okay because your parents are there with you. When you do a minute, try 5 minutes. Then try 10 minutes, 15 minutes, and then maybe you don't need your parents there with you. You could go to sleep by yourself without a nightlight, without any light. That's gonna be wonderful. It's gonna take time, but you could get there. And if you pray to God, you could do it. Of course you can. I believe in you. Here we have a microphone. Some people are scared to talk in public, to speak in public, to, I don't know, for other people to hear them. So if that's you, you could record yourself and then make your parents post it on Facebook or Instagram or whatever they have, whatever social media they have. And that way it really takes courage to put yourself where other people could see you. And that is a great way. If that's something that your parents could do, that is amazing. But if not, just record yourself a video and see it. And that way you could see, wow, I'm actually pretty good at talking in public and look at how many people like it. So whatever you guys do that it can help you overcome that fear, it's always really good and very welcome. So right here we have a mountain. That mountain is for heights. A lot of people are afraid of heights. I really don't have an idea of what you guys could do at home for heights, but if you guys are gonna do something, let me know down in the comments and do it with your parents, because that's very important. So let me know and send us your courage boards. And thank you so much for letting me be here another week. I love you guys and hope to see you guys really soon. Gracias a ustedes por otra semana que puedo estar acá con ustedes. Mándanos fotos si van a estar haciendo esto del el courage board, del el cuadro del coraje. Los quiero mucho y espero verlos muy muy pronto. Besitos, bye, bendiciones. Bye, guys.
What an awesome class, guys. Well, from Chilo and myself, we want to say see you next week and be safe out there.
Bye, guys.
Bye, guys.